Good evening, everyone, and welcome to This Week in Review. In relation to last week, we spoke to Mr. Marsden, principal of the St. John's Central High School. We have this to show you. Mr. Marsden, there is some controversy over the change of the school hours. Why did the school hours change?
Okay, Gail. Perhaps I might start by explaining that we have four or five different reasons that we think are legitimate and real reasons for change. To begin with, our school is probably the odd one out in the district. We're later starting in the day and we're later ending. That was one reason. We looked at things like another reason, for example, that parents getting off work at the plant could pick up their children at lunch hour, time they get off the plant, pick them up and take them home. Mm-hmm. And they could also they would also pick them up on their way back, which would give the kids an opportunity then to be home with their parents at that particular time for that hour. That's another reason. A third reason might be that there would be more time in the afternoon. For example, for us, for staff meetings, our meetings sometimes drag on into 5:30, quarter to six, and on. We found there would be a little more time for staff meetings. We also found that, for children, they like to have time in the evenings, more time in the evenings. Mm-hmm. Extracurricular activities, for example, and that would give them a better chance. Another reason might be that we've seen, for example, a lot of kids who are back to school, waiting outside a long time before the bell even rings. Now, I know these are kids that are close to the area, but we've said, if there's some way that we can cut down on that amount of time, the kids are just out standing around, before people get in, then that would be another reason. As I pointed out earlier, to bring us in line with what's happening in the rest of the schools and district. Some schools, for example, in the Cornerbrook area, school begins even before 8:30, mm-hmm. And kids get out about 2:30 in the afternoon. I know that's not a real reason. We don't have to do as other schools do. That's completely our choice between those two schools here and working in conjunction with the bus schedule. Mm-hmm. But for these reasons, and reasons that are supported in a survey and what students like and what teachers like, overwhelmingly, mm-hmm. that most of the people wanted a change in our schedule.
I see. Okay. How was the survey done? Maybe you could tell us a bit about the survey.
Okay. The survey that was done was conducted by Mr. Benight in his math class. Every year as a study there, they do surveys and you pull information together and you see how people think. What's done in a lot of surveys, for example, on opinion polls. Let's look at something that might be political. Let's suppose you want to find out about chance of a candidate running in an election. Mm-hmm. They wouldn't contact every single person, in Burjo or in a certain area. What they would do would be to draw a sample. In other words, they might contact so many people in the district. And from then they can judge within reasonable accuracy, what most people think. Mm-hmm. Actually, the survey that we did, we targeted every single parent in Burjo. That was our target. And the kids were given about a week, 3 or 4 days, and the areas were divided up. And I can show these on the
on
TV.
We'll see that now.
Gail, this is a copy of the survey that went out to students, for example, in grades 4, 5, and 6, students in 7, 8, and 9, students in 10, 11, and 12, and to parents, and also to teachers. Now, as I said, that we try to target all of the parents in Burjo. And here's a copy of it. What basically it says is that schedule remain as is. Begin earlier and end earlier. That was another option. For example, it would be 8:30 until 3. Begin later and end later was another option. And fourthly, begin the same as now with shorter recess and lunch and end earlier. basically that was a survey that went out to all people that were part of this. On the parent survey, this is what we found. And there were 12 areas. For example, there was Muddy Hole, there was Mrs. Hill, there was West Muddy Hole, there was Reach, Little Muddy Hole, the Arbor, the Point, Messers, not sure about that one, Ayers Hill, Smalls Island, and again Messers. Trailer Court right here. So there were 12 areas that we targeted and that the students took their little survey around and found out people's opinion. Now, the response that we got, we heard, for example, from 323 parents on this survey, which is a good sample. This is a good sample. And of that, you can see here that 49% of the parents wanted to begin school earlier and end earlier. Now, the other 16% here wanted to begin the same as now, wanted to cut lunch and recess and end earlier. So lumping these together, those that want to change, there's really about 65% of the parents that want to change. Now, if I go to the students in 10, 11, and 12, there were 60% of the students who wanted to begin earlier and end earlier. Okay? In 7, 8, and 9, again, there were 62% of the students who wanted to begin school earlier and end earlier. Some junior high. And in the elementary school, in grades 4, 5, and 6, we saw that 58% of the students wanted to begin earlier and end earlier. So you can see that on that particular survey, the majority of the parents and students, both in the elementary school and the high school, want to begin school earlier and end earlier. Okay, realizing that there was a need for change, as parents told to us in the survey, and as students in the elementary school, and as students in high school indicated to us by a majority of people, that we then started trying to draw up a schedule. Mm-hmm. We had a joint meeting of both staffs, the elementary school and the high school, and we looked at the different schedules. Matter of fact, we looked at 6 different schedules. And what we then did, we went through a series of voting on them. What schedule are we going to use? And at each time we would eliminate the one with the lowest number of votes. So we went through a number of ballots that way. And all teachers were part of this, they had input into it, and eventually it rolled down and it came to the schedule that we now have in operation. Mm-hmm. And we feel that this was a fair way. It was not something that was thought up by just a few students, or rather a few teachers, mm-hmm. because all teachers were party to it.
I see. Did you receive many complaints since you decided to school change?
Gail, we received a number of concerns from parents, and these will be addressed when we have our meeting on March the 13th, that's next Tuesday. These will be brought to the attention of teachers. Some of them already have, by the way, letters mm-hmm. that came in, teachers were made aware of. And we realize that there is a need for change, particularly in the Mr.'s area. It doesn't appear that the kids in that area are getting enough time for lunch. And that's a real concern. And we want to address that concern. And we'll do that in our meeting. But getting back to your question, we had about 3 or 4 letters from parents and 3 or 4 phone calls. But again, as I say, since majority of parents and students and teachers want this, and they are out there. We haven't asked them to come forward because that's not really necessary. Mm-hmm. But you know, it needs time. For example, I had a call on when we started a new schedule before the bus even made a run. I had concerns from parents saying, you know, we're drawing off a petition. But the thing wasn't given the chance to run. And it's fair. I mean, we would welcome a petition if they want to do it. It will be looked at because a petition is only a request for change. It's not necessary that a change will be made. But in this particular case, where people have a real concern and we can see it coming through in Mr.'s area at lunchtime, mm-hmm. We need to take a look at that. We certainly will.
I see. I understand that the hour change is on a trial basis now for a month. How will you decide if the change will stay or not? Will there be another survey conducted? Or?
No. What we did originally when we talked about this, when we planned the schedule and it was put on TV, we indicated at that time that we would review it, you know, and if we're having real problems for it, well, then we would go about change. With respect to a survey, it's not really necessary, you know, to conduct another survey. We know what parents have said to us. Mm-hmm. We know what students have said, and we know what teachers are saying. And we had reasons there. It's not going to get down to, Gail, a point where it's, you know, you go at this again, because I'm sure that if I did this, again, you would have two sides. There are two groups mm-hmm. of people out there, you see. And the majority right now want us to change the schedule. And really, that's all we can do. We try and adjust that concern mm-hmm. and, you know, the concerns that people have. So we know what they are. Mm-hmm. So really, another survey is not necessary.
I see. How is it going overall over the past week? Have you seen any major problems with it? Or?
With respect to the bus traveling, yes, we've seen ways there where, for example, mm-hmm. the bus came, kids don't have to be in class until 1:04 in the afternoon. The buses arrived one particular day at 12:52, parked out near the school. And we've indicated that the times would change, you know, as the bus completes a run around town, bearing in mind that there's traffic coming from the plant, that it would be necessary to change time. But it had to be done on an experimental basis mm-hmm. first. And we're getting that narrowed down now. As a matter of fact, Mr. Sims and I are planning on traveling on the bus to see what's happening.
I see.
And tomorrow. So in that way we can get probably a better idea.
Yeah.
But we know what the concerns are, parents, but we just want to just see where maybe there are ways that we can improve this. We want to look at all the possibilities.
Okay. Are there any other comments you would like to make, Mr. Marsden?
No, I have nothing further, Gail, other than that. I would ask that people bear with us. We're trying to adjust the, or look at the concerns. And hopefully we can put something into place that will take care of these concerns that are out there.
I see. Okay, thank you very much.
You're
Mr.
welcome.
Now we have Vicki with the Junior High School Report.
Thank you, Gail. Good evening. And this just CH Junior High News this week. The week of March 4th to 10th was Education Week. On Monday, the school had an assembly to start it all off. There were speakers and music. This year's Education Week theme is Saving Our Planet, Educating Our World. On Wednesday after dinner, the old school went to the ball field for their annual winter frolic. They played soccer, tug of war, skated, and skied. Afterwards, they had hot chocolate in the community center. On Friday afternoon, the school held a variety show, including lip singing and skits. During the week, some classes did their own things together as a group. For example, the grade 7s did projects for social studies. Here are a few clips of them. Essay contest and a poster contest. This has to be passed in by Monday, tomorrow. Thank you. And now back to you, Gail.
Thank you, Vicki. That's it for tonight's program. Please stay tuned for the bandwagon on behalf of BBS, BBS volunteers, and the correspondents, I'm Gail Swift wishing you a great week. Good night.